Thanks for joining me today. We're going to go through all the music I've been listening to through this month, April of 2020. During self-isolation, I've had more time than ever to discover new music and communicate with some great up-and-coming artists. I'm going to share with you all the top music that I found, what's on the top of my playlist this month. We'll start off with Run by Joji. Now, Joji is someone that's been around. He's become extremely popular online, but it's somebody that I recently found out about. So I know I'm late in the game here, I'm late to the party, but I'm really glad that I've found him because he is genius level as far as talent is concerned. I know he just released Give Me Love, which is a fantastic video as well. The one that's getting the most play in my house right now is Run. I love the use of guitars for the beat, as well as one of the best guitar solos that I've heard in a pop song in a long time. He is basically the perfect YouTube artist for the modern era because not only is he interesting musically, but he's mesmerizing to look at. He's very emotive with his face. I don't know how great an actor he'd be with lines, but in a silent movie or in a video like this, his face is so emotive that it's absolutely fantastic to watch. He adds so much to the videos. I'm sure that's something that's a talent that he's honed through his Filthy Frank and Pink Boy videos, which have become very popular. So Run by Joji is my first song. Number two is Ooh La La by Run the Jewels. Now, Run the Jewels is one of the few groups that's a little older, but very successful in hip-hop. For whatever reason, if you're under 25, usually you're the only people that rap fans are listening to, but Run the Jewels have been around for a long time. LP's been making fantastic beats for a long time, so I'm really glad that he's so successful right now, and I hope that people will realize that there are a lot of excellent artists that are making music who have been around for a long time. Another example is Eric Sermon. We'll have a track from Vernia, his recent album, later on in the playlist. Run the Jewels' song Ooh La La features an awesome sample from Greg Nice, who is the prominent aspect of the hook. Unfortunately, he doesn't appear doing a verse. When it said featuring Greg Nice, I was hoping to hear more from him, but that was not the case. But there are some fantastic scratches by DJ Premier. You have excellent verses from both Killer Mike and LP, and as usual, a great beat. If you like LP, I would highly recommend that you go back to see where it all started, and that's with the Cannibal Ox album, The Cold Vein. I mean, he did a lot of music back then, but that album, to me, is my personal favorite of that era, where you can hear the experimental, really unique sound that LP cultivated and has honed through the years, and you'll still get glimpses of that in Run the Jewels. In The Cold Vein by Cannibal Ox, you really hear a very dark, murky sound, extremely distinctive and really, really powerful. So I'd highly recommend that you check that album out. And the third song is Dragon Ball Durag by Thundercat, which is a lot of fun. When I listen to 70s funk and I think, why don't people make music like that anymore? Well, they do. Thundercat does. And he does a great job of having a real authenticism to that sound. He's not just copying that. He's showing a lot of love for it and he's creating it. You have the falsetto vocals. You have the bouncing bass lines. The video is so much fun. Right now, I think we all need to smile. And it's nice to see an artist in the hip-hop world who doesn't take himself too seriously. Even this is funk, it's still related to hip-hop as well, in my opinion. It's nice to see someone who's willing to joke around and enjoy himself. So this is a great trio to start with, and I'll see you right back here after those songs.